Keep moving forward, right?
Of course, right. Alright. So, well, actually, no. I actually want to do it like this. Da-da-da! Large soul is... Let's look and see what we've got. 3,396, it's probably not going to be enough. From zero, I don't think that's going to be enough. And we don't want to be running around with souls that we can lose for no reason. Though it would be nice to buy a miracle from him, but not necessary right now. But I think after we beat the next boss, we will buy a miracle from him. Hi, guys! We're not going that way, though. We're gonna go this way. Up the stairs! And there's another one of these. Turtle up. Meh. Sucky trade, but it worked. Do not like him. He's a channeler. And he's here for an important reason that we'll get into later once we find out where he comes from. But just suffice it to say, he's a wizard who buffs up little hollows like this. He buffs up their damage, but not their health. So they can do all kinds of horrible things to me. But they still are just as weak. Yay! I got them all! I think I got hit once. But I got them all! Oh man, it's weird. So then fighting him is gonna suck. Because he's got soul arrows! Aye. But he's relatively weak. And he got 1,000 souls, so there's that. Hello, friend! Not very friendly. With his sword and his shield, and he's gonna try and hit me. Up. Oh. Up. Oh. That was a weird input thing where I hit three times, but then I didn't. Come on now. Come on now. There we go. Praise the sun! That's a Solaire thing. Just in case anybody doesn't know, that's a Solaire thing. Where... I think he says praise the sun at something, but there's a gesture called praise the sun, and it's what he always does. We'll see in a minute. But we gotta go here first. And we gotta meet another NPC! NPCs galore!
Still human, are you?
Not
then
necessarily.
I am in luck.
Maybe you are?
Could you help me?
Perhaps.
As you can see, I am stuck without recourse.
This is Lautrec. Lautrec, the Embraced. So, yeah. This is him.
Thank you. Yes. Sincerely. I am Knight Lautrec. Of Kharim.
I appreciate
this. And I guarantee a reward. Only later. Yes, very sorry. Your reward will have to wait. I've just been freed. Allow me some time. I am free. Now, I can get back to work.
Because that's not an evil laugh at all.
I am free.
So there's another one. That is someone else in their game beating it. And then ringing it in my game. Which I still think is so cool. It's a really cool little detail that they did. Item, humanity. So I think we're gonna go do the Firekeeper's Soul now. Since I've introduced a very important character in that arc, I guess. But basically, that way is up to the boss, and there are no enemies between here and there. So all the enemies that we faced are the enemies that we're going to face on the way to the boss. Minus two, actually. Two of them are not going to show up in our little boss run, but we're going to run down to Firelink first. Now, I might have enough for a level. Which would be important to put into endurance right now, actually, because I need a better equip load. And if not, I can definitely buy a miracle, so then I can have a heal, which is nice. Having 13 to 15 heals somewhere in there would be nice. So, no, we're not going to do that yet. We're actually going to go down here. We're going to go downstairs. Lautrec, he's here.
Ah, hello there. I have your reward. Please, accept it.
A sunlight medal.
I'm grateful to you
which
for
is weird.
Freeing me. Not enough for you. Well, let's not be greedy now. By the Lord, your face. Your humanity is really slipping, but there are methods. Most fools have more humanity than they know what to do with. Now, who do you imagine will make the best use of it? You again. What is it? Our futures are murky. Let's not be too friendly now.
Yeah, let's not, actually. Let's not be too friendly.
Our future.
Okay, so that's all of his dialogue. Look, there's somebody in there. That is our Firekeeper. She's the keeper of Firelink Shrine. So, she can't speak. So there's no response. But we can reinforce the Essence Flask using a Firekeeper's Soul. So let's look at that sunlight metal. This faintly warm metal, engraved with the symbol of the sun, is the ultimate honor awarded to those who summon the Warrior of Sunlight and complete a goal. The symbol represents Lord Gwyn's firstborn, who lost his deity status and was expunged from the annals. Expunged from the annals. He lost his deity status, he was no longer worshipped, and then he was expunged from the annals. But the old god of war still watches closely over his warriors. So, the weird thing is, our Sir Lautrec right here, he is not a Sunbro. He is not part of the Covenant of Sunlight. So, he acquired it somehow. Maybe, you know, and he seems vaguely diabolical. You know, he seems like, oh, you know, who's gonna put humanity to better use? Me or them? Probably he's gonna pick him, right? Not exactly the nicest guy. So, there's that. But, Solaire actually is a part of that covenant, which we'll see once we get to the place where we can defeat that dragon so we can get through. Because it's at that bonfire. I can probably level up and... There we go. 59, that's all. I still have the slow roll. I wish I had some nicer pants so that I could... Okay, so... 6644. Huh, that's weird. Look at how... Huh. So those are my real defense. See, I'm only at 15, but I have that slower roll. Which is aggravating. Because I'm only at, what, a quarter? Yeah, I'm only at barely over... approximately a quarter of my clip load. And I have that slower roll. So, we've got, it looks like the left number is what my physical defense actually is, and then the parentheses number is what the actual number when I get hit is. Or maybe that's without the shield, and then the left number is with the shield. That would make a little more sense. Yeah, I think that's it. So let's see if Crest's Fallen has anything to say.
Have you seen that terribly morose lass?
I have.
The fire keeper. She's stuck keeping that bonfire lit. Sad, really. She's mute and bound to this forsaken place. They probably cut her tongue out back in her village so that she'd never say any god's name in vain. How do these martyrs keep chugging along? I'd peter out in an instant. What now? I'm not up for chatting. Leave me alone.
So that's kind of important. We've got... I'll just tell you guys her name. Her name's Anastasia, our firekeeper down here. She had her tongue cut out of her face. He says probably by her village, back before she was a firekeeper, so that she would never take a god's name in vain again. Which we don't really know what that entails.
Oh, miracle.
I can't afford heal because man. But yeah, it's 5 uses, so it will be 15 heals.
Come again. The effective.
Yeah. So at that point, it was a level or a miracle. Which, this, you know, I'm gonna say level before miracle. But we've still got that crappy roll, which is annoying. But we're gonna... Oh, idiot. I have to go back down. Because I have to hit that bonfire again. While we're doing this, we'll just... pop a humanity, because we are going to summon for this boss fight. So I need a humanity. But we're only summoning NPCs. Like I said, not really cheating. Especially since in Dark Souls 2, you can only advance people's storylines if you summon them into boss fights. You know, some characters like Luke Teal, and I think there's a couple others. Ben Hart and Luke Teal, I know definitely. And the annoying thing is I screwed up both of their storylines, so I couldn't get their equipment, and I really, really wanted it too. Like, I really wanted their equipment, and I just screwed up the stuff, so I couldn't get it. It was super annoying. But I'm going to try it again on New Game Plus, and hopefully I can not screw up their storylines. But that's why I'm looking up storylines. You know, I'm using the wiki to make sure I get the ending that I believe is canonical, so that I don't screw it up. But I got Siegmeier's correct when I was playing before on that other Alaric character that you guys saw. No item. Okay. Up we go. And that's another one. That is so cool. That's right. Just a broken straight sword. That's not of any use. No use at all. Okay. So up here. Wait, we should totally have... Did I miss it? I think I might have missed it. There's one more summon in here. Yep, there it is. Yep, Lautrec. So I can get Lautrec in here. And I can bring in... Oop, come on. Let me do it. And I can bring in Solaire. See, watch, ready? That's the Praise the Sun. For you newbies. But he's got a shield and a Sunlight Greatsword, and he's got like two sides. Sides, that's what it's called. Cutscene!
Thank you.
So this is the Bell Gargoyle. I'm gonna go for his tail, because this is another one where he can... Oh, nope. Come on now. Don't give me trouble. Wow, they are just beating him into a corner. He doesn't know what to do. Oh, I hit him in the face. I need to hit his tail. There we go. There we go! Wow, this is going way quick. See, and when he gets to half health, whoop, another one shows up. Which has fur! It blows fur! And he has no tail, so we can't get anything. But he blows fire, and it's over. That quick. I also got the gargoyle helm. Thanks, friends. Twin humanities and a sunlight medal. The sunlight medal did not come from Lautrec. The sunlight medal comes from Solaire. Okay? Solaire is the only person that gives sunlight medals when you co-op. Or other people with those big golden ones like you saw. Because they're part of the Sunlight Covenant, so you get a Sunlight Medal from them. Right? So that's why I think that Lautrec came across the Sunlight Medal through less moral means. Probably murder. Oh, he's not here yet. Okay. There's an NPC that shows up there, but he's not here yet. So that was the gargoyles. Man, it happened real quick. That actually happened quicker than I think it's ever happened before. But then we climb all the way up this tower here. See, there are more gargoyles, but those are definitely stone ones. They're not like the other ones. I did it! Congratulations, whoever you are. Ding dong. See, now other people hear that in their game. That's the first bell of awakening. Okay. So we did our first bell of awakening. Super boss beat. It's good. And they literally had, like, no chance. I felt... There he is!
Greetings. I am Oswald of Kareem, the Pardoner. Thou art a friend. For thee, a warm welcome. Cometh thou to confess, or to accuse? For indeed, all sin is my domain.
I like that one. Okay, so there's a purging stone, there's an indictment which reports his trespass of invader, which I think this is actually the indictment and the Book of the Guilty are multiplayer items. Then we've got Homeward Bones, We got Karmic Justice, which is a spell. Oh, no, it's a miracle. It's a miracle. Miracle of Black-Haired Witch Velka. Velka. See, this is it. Temporary auto-counter versus heavy damage. So, that's kind of cool. For each sin, there is a punishment, and it is the task of Goddess Velka to define the sin and mete out the punishment. She is the goddess... She's the only goddess in the Dark Souls universe. She's the goddess of sin. Meaning that sin, or punishment, is her domain. This is a Velka's talisman. Medium for casting miracles of the gods. This black tuft of hair that serves as a talisman belongs to Velka, goddess of sin. It casts miracles not by drawing upon faith, but intelligence. So... Basically, you can use spells and miracles with this, because then it draws on, you know, it scales with magic rather than faith. Because intelligence is magic, basically. Now we've got the Blood Bite Ring, which is one of the infamous bite rings commissioned by Sir Arster of Kareem. Despite the dreadful rumors surrounding its creation, this ring is an unmistakable asset in its ability to help prevent bleeding, which would be very good in the next area, but I'm not going to use it. There's the Poison Bite Ring as well, which is the same, except it's poison. And then there's the Ring of Sacrifice, which we've already seen, and that's all.
Thou art welcome any time. It is only human to commit a sin. Greetings, and welcome back. I am pleased to see the preserving thine humanity.
Okay, so that's...
Thou art welcome any time. It is only human to commit a sin.
So, he and, oh, God, what's his name? The cleric. No, he's from Thurland. He and, no. Who else is from Kareem? Because Sigmar's from Katarina. The cleric whose name escapes me is from Thurland. Oh God, I can't remember. But there's more people from Kareem, which we'll meet. But first, we're not gonna test our luck. We're gonna go straight back to the bonfire. We're gonna make a beeline for the bonfire. And then we're gonna go to an area that I hate, personally. Don't like it. Don't like it at all. Oh, pff, stupid. Back to the Firelink. I love how the music just swells in like that. It's super good. So we're gonna level up. We can put 2 in endurance, which would be good. I don't know. Screw it. We're gonna put it in there. It also does our bleed resist, which is going to be good for the next area. Still, no quick roll. I should have probably put that in strength so that we could get closer to the Spyhander, but, you know. How is it in terms of weight? 6, 10. Yeah, it's way worse. So here's the gargoyle tail axe that we got. The sliced tail of the gargoyle guarding the Bell of Awakening in the Undead Church, or patrolling in Anor Londo. Can be used as a bronze battle axe, bends dramatically during large attacks, owing to its nature as a tail. Yeah, I know. But see, it... Well, wow, look at the blade resist. Look at the blade there. But it's weird, because it puts bleed on us, right? So... No, still not. But it's a big old battle axe that we're not going to be using. But in big attacks, it curls around like because it's a tail. You know, it's kind of interesting. But we're not going to use that. We're going to go back to the Drake Sword. But we are going to look at the helm. Gargoyle helm. Helm of the Gargoyle, an enchanted creature that guarded the Bell of Awakening in the Belfry of the Undead Church, as bronze helm, was for mere appearance sake, as Gargoyle's skin is naturally hard, little in the way of defense can be expected from it. But it's light. It's lighter than the Night Helm. Only slightly, though. And it looks kind of cool, right? Doesn't help us, you know, weight-wise, obviously. I really, really need the shadow outfit. Because I really, really like the shadow set. Except for the headpiece. Because I don't usually play like a ninja-looking character, and, you know, it makes you look a little too ninja. For my taste.